Hey everyone, Token Dave over here. The dorky token black guy that's just trying to get by and is late for work. So I'm actually in the train station right now because I'm waiting for my bus to come and it's pouring rain outside. So basically, I have a few minutes to chill out and wait out the time before I go back outside. Anyway, it is Friday, January 7th, and Spider-Man Homecoming is finally out today. Won't be able to see it till won't be able to see it probably till Sunday. And it's great to see Spider-Man in the MCU, finally. And the Vulture being in the movie. Something all Spider-Man fans want. However, you know, there are other Spider-Man villains that have yet to be displayed in a movie that I really feel needs their time in the spotlight. And since I haven't done a top 10 of this yet, I'm going to give my top 10 villains that I would like to see in a Spider-Man movie. And starting with number 10, Doppelganger. Now, in Infinity Gauntlet, basically, spoiler alert, all Earthbound Marvel heroes were part of an army in an onslaught against Thanos. They all died. And they got brought back to life later by the Infinity Gauntlet. Infinity War is a sequel to Infinity Gauntlet, and it is revealed that all those heroes that died ended up having evil doppelgangers. And Spider-Man was one of them. And this doppelganger basically has two sets of arms, legs, has multiple eyes, and fangs and claws, and is, while would not be a great villain on his own, would be a great obstacle for Spider-Man to go against. So I would love to see Doppelganger in a Spider-Man movie. Number nine is Tarantula. Continuing, like, you know, the arachnid motif that's going on, Tarantula is a little different. See, Tarantula is more of the Captain America for South America, only worldwide he's known as a terrorist. And he is like a highly trained government agent with Olympic level gymnastics and a really, really formidable kickboxer. And the South American government injects him with a serum towards the end of his villainy career. And basically, that's when he gains three spider powers and is able to have the strength of a spider, shoot webs, and mimics the spider sense. Multiple people were the Tarantula, but the Tarantula that I'm talking about is the original, all right? That's Anti-Miguel Rodriguez. Number eight is Puma. Now, Puma, I have a bit of a soft spot for because Puma was the first supervillain in a comic, the Spider-Man comic that I ever read. And basically, his name is Thomas Firebird, who's a Native American, and he is basically a humanoid wildcat, you know, and he has heightened senses, heightened strength, heightened agility, and, you know, he's a mercenary. Funny, the thing is, though, while he was the first supervillain that I read, he was also a Spider-Man's. He became, in all comic books, the first villain that I was aware of that became a good guy. And something that we haven't really seen in the movies, like a supervillain that has no connection, with a hero previously, you know, he turns a cheek and everything, turns a good leaf, and that would be interesting to see. Number seven is the Chameleon, the first villain Spider-Man ever faced. And, you know, while he's the first villain Spider-Man ever faced, he's so low on the list because primarily, you know, he able to disguise himself as other people. You know, the 90s cartoon gave him a better interpretation, you know, but at his core, he's just like, you know, he's basically a man of a thousand faces, just like the old actor who I keep forgetting his name. I can't believe it. Sorry about that. But he's just like, you know, a common low-level thug. But it would be nice to see the Chameleon actually be one of Spider-Man's villains, especially since he can disguise himself, and basically it could be more of a cat and mouse thriller action movie and everything. That's in that I would love to see. All right. Number six. Number six is Hydro Man. Now, Hydro Man, aka Maury Birch. Oh wait. I think I'm getting his last name right. Okay. Oh man, having a brain fart early in the morning. But much before, Maury was basically, you know, a naval seaman and everything, and he was in the way of a fight that Spider-Man and Submariner were having, and he gets knocked off a ship into a water, where the water mixed with some chemicals that changed his molecular structure, and he's able to control water when he's around him, and is able to basically shape his body into liquid molecules. Something that can easily pulled off because be pulled off in movies because we've seen the T-1000 by now. And you know, he would be a good, you know, basically street level criminal because that's all he is. You know, he's nothing really big or fancy and everything. He basically does a lot of robberies and some kidnappings, and he's mostly known to be part, like, you know, of a team, like the Fearsome Four or the Sinister Six. But he would be a good antagonist to see to have Spider-Man go against in the big screen. Alright? So, number five. Number five, I have the Spider-Slayer, aka Alistair Smythe. Now, this is actually more of a humanoid cybernetic Spider-Slayer. There's the original Spider-Slayers, which were a bunch of robots that were done by, Smeagol Smythe. But Smeagol Smythe died from radiation poisoning trying to create the Spider-Slayers. His son, Alistair, became, like, you know, advanced in cybernetics, and he decided to, you know, make himself a Spider Slayer to go against Spider-Man. So, all Spider-Man's powers, but with advanced weapons. Freaking awesome. Freaking awesome. I know I said he was number five, but no, he's really number six. My fault. Number five is actually, number five is actually Calypso. Alright? Now, the reason why I put Calypso is she's closely linked to number three. But I had to put her here because basically, you know, she's basically a voodoo priestess and everything. And, like, you know, she has a personal vendetta against Spider-Man and everything because of her former lover. And I think it would be kind of awesome to see a female go up against Spider-Man who is able to control zombies, because that's what she's done, which is awesome. Oh, and by the way, Sally Calypso is the only female villain on my list. Number four is Jack-O-Lantern. Now, people call him a bit of a ripoff of the Green Goblin and the Hobgoblin, but he's a little bit more cool. You know, see, and there's been multiple Jack-O-Lanterns, but I'm going with the original. Jason Markendale and everything. And Jason Masondale is an ex-CIA agent who was disgraced, and, like, basically, one of the villains that Spider-Man originally faced, the Tinker, made a bunch of, like, you know, gadgets and weapons for him, and he became Green Goblin-like. The only thing is, his head is a freaking flaming skull, you know, crazier weapons than the Green Goblin and the Hobgoblin, and would be a cool threat. And also, keep in mind that Jack-O-Lantern also encountered Captain America too, so that would be a bit interesting, you know. So Jack-O-Lantern go either way, but I'd rather see this Spider-Man. All right. Number three, Kraven the Hunter. Sergei Kravinoff, you know, basically, you know, a sportsman and everything, someone that likes to hunt wild exotic animals, is only after Spider-Man because he's big game, and he has peak human strength and everything, great agility, and, like, you know, is one of the characters that has one of the best Spider-Man stories, Kraven's Last Hunt, which is, to be honest, that is actually, like, my second favorite Spider-Man story of all time, thus far, you know. Then again, I haven't read a Spider-Man comic in years because it's kind of convoluted right now. But anyway, Kraven the Hunter would be a great villain to see on screen. Number two is the Scorpion. Oh, wow, the Scorpion. talk about the total opposite of Spider-Man. Scorpion, a natural hunter of spiders and everything, is stronger than Spider-Man, has a poisonous sting and everything, and while he, like Doppelganger, he's more of a physical threat to him, more of an obstacle or more of a forcer, you know. He's actually a little more dangerous because, like, basically, he has, like, destroyed, like, you know, basically, a huge sections of the boroughs of New York City. And, interestingly enough, he also had the Venom symbiote for a little bit, which was awesome, considering. So, Scorpion would be, and Scorpion's another villain that a lot of Spider-Man fans want to see in the movies. And I gotta wrap this up because I gotta go ahead and bust, but number one is Mysterio. Quentin Beck, special effects artist who, like Chameleon, could easily frame Spider-Man by basically like using special effects, decoys and everything, and traps, you know, another like, you know, more of a mental and special effects friendly, you know, villain that would be great to be seen in the movies. Great eye candy, great thinking villain and everything, something that Spider-Man has to match wits with constantly. So those are my top 10 villains I'd like to see in a Spider-Man movie. Agree? Disagree? Drop me a comment, give me a like, and subscribe. Ring that bell when a new video is loaded, and spread this video out. But until then, this has been Token Dave, the Token Black Guy, just trying to get by. I'll catch you guys later.